Hey folks, all right, so here we are. I did a boat tour on my last year's Basscat. I wanna do a boat tour on my new Basscat. This is a 2019 Basscat Era. Got the Gatorland wrap on it, Neat Company's wrap, Basscat on the boat there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna kinda dive inside. I know we're in the garage, as you can see. It's freaking pouring outside. It is Florida, summertime. So real quick, I guess we'll just start off on the outside. Got the wrap done by Media One Wrap This in Longwood, Florida. You gotta check them out if you're looking for a boat wrap. Ask for Damon, tell him I sent you. Show you the trailer here. Got some nice black rims on the trailer. You can get them on your Basscat. That's from the factory there. Went with the matte finish this year. Last year I went with the glossy finish. Went with a different color this year. I love gray. It's one of my favorite colors. So I went with the gray and black on the truck and the boat. So this is the outside. We'll jump back in the back of the boat here and do the front. We'll just do kind of the whole thing. So I guess we'll start from the front and work our way back. All right, so we're going to start at the front of the boat. Real quick, right here, we got the Minn Kota Ultrex 112, 36 volt. This thing's a beast. My first one I've had. I absolutely love it. Best trolling motor I've ever had. Gotta have the Hydro Wave. I actually have that mounted right here. Just TH Marine Hydro Wave. I use it all the time. Anytime you have suspending fish, schooling fish that go down, whatever, I turn that on. It works. I promise you it works. Definitely a must have. As you can see right here, I have my Lowrance HDS9. This is a live unit. You're probably wondering where this unit is. This one's in the house. So when I'm not fishing tournaments, I take it in, I'll hook it up. I have a power cable inside. I go on and I play with mapping, look around for my next tournaments at James River. I've been looking a lot there. So I use that, and that is why that is not here. Down here in Florida, I really don't need a big graph up when I'm fishing around home here. So I just keep this one in the house and use it for map study. I have this one up front here mounted on a KVD Kong mount. Easy remove. I can remove it real easy when I go to the hotel. Pretty quick. All you got to do is loosen it up here. And then just take it off, put it in the hotel, put it in my truck, whatever. This one I have locked on here. Nobody can get it off. This one is mounted on a, I want to say, Bass Boat Technologies mount. And this is also a Bass Boat Technologies mount. It's just shorter arm to keep my unit from being super high. So it just shortens it up a little bit. That's my front setup there. I got my power pole buttons here. They're kind of hidden, so I can't see them. Up and down. In the past, I ran them on each side. For whatever reason this year, I went with them closer together. My reasoning for it is when I had the one here, when I'd step in the front of the boat, I'd step on the button and I, you know, they'd go off. So I just put them there underneath the trolling motor. They're away from everything and protected. So another cool little tip, while I put this cover back on, for those of you that have covers blowing off when you go down the road, you just go buy some Velcro and strap them on there. So that's what I do. Pretty easy, and keeps your covers from blowing off. So yeah, that's that. That's the front of the boat. Now we'll kind of go front deck under my lids, and we'll work our way back. All right, so here we are in the front of the Basscat. This is a Basscat Era. Again, I highly recommend, if you're in the market for a Basscat or you're looking into buying a Basscat, make sure you get the padded front deck. This is my first one I've ordered. This is my third Basscat Era I've had. This is the third boat I've ordered, and this is the first time I've got a padded front deck, and I absolutely love it. My feet don't hurt after long days of practice. My back doesn't hurt. It's just real nice, and you know, makes fishing a lot more enjoyable. It is fun, but you know, long days, 14-hour days of practice, it gets rough after a little while, especially when your feet hurt, your back hurt, stuff like that. You go up north, waves beat the crap out of you. On your trolling motor, you're going up and down constantly, you know, and this is going to save your feet, so, and your back. So, as you see, the deck layout here on the Basscat Era is a little different from all your other traditional bass boats. This is actually a little different from my last year's boat. I now have a split lid here, where it used to be one full lid. So, this is a day box, so I want to show you guys my day box here and let you see what I got going on, so come check it out. All right, so here you got my day box right here. Cool little deal here. This is actually a makeup holder that I got, and It works great to hold your tools. I keep some extra scissors in there. I got a razor blade, hook sharpeners, treble hook changers, my Spike-It pens. Right here, I got tons of different colors of Spike-It. Keep them in there in case I gotta change a bait real quick. This is pretty cool. I highly recommend this too. Little tool, if you guys, you know, you're using your reels, they might get loose over time. You can quick tighten them up. That way they're good, stay together, everything's tight. Keep rattles in here for worms, worm rattles, flipping rattles, whatever. Keep them in there. Also have right here, bobber stops. Keep them in there. And leader line. Keep this up front here. That way if I need to tie a leader on real quick, whether I'm flipping or I'm up north drop shotting, I can quick tie on a leader line on my rods and I'm set. Keep it right here. Real easy to get to. Now on a tournament day, if I'm catching them on a Reaction Innovation Sweet Beaver and Hematoma, I got my color dialed in, I got everything picked out, I'll keep my baits up here. So all I gotta do throughout the day, if I catch one, need a new plastic, just run in, you know, open this lid up real quick, grab the bag, put a new plastic on, throw the bag back in here, shut it and go on. So that's that box. Now we're gonna, you know, jump into this box here. This is the driver's side rod box. I don't use it for rods. I load it with tackle. So this is where I keep all of my hard baits. Most important thing right there, life jacket. Highly recommend wearing a life jacket anytime you're out on the water. But more importantly, definitely need one of these. This is a rescue link. This thing right here will save your life. It's a GPS tracking device. If for whatever reason you get thrown out of your boat, or your boat, you know, is gone, you get thrown out and, you know, you have no way of getting back, or you need to be, you know, found, rescued, definitely this thing right here will save your life. So I keep that right here in my zipper, in my life jacket. Never leaves there. I check it, you know, to make sure it works. Occasionally I'll check it and, you know, just keep it right there. Always wear this life jacket. I wear this life jacket summertime, winter, whatever, rain, shine, don't care. Also keep my Sims rain gear in here. Got to keep that in the boat. You know, some people keep it in the truck. I keep some spare Sims gear in the truck just in case it would rain. You know, this suit gets wet, I got a dry one in the truck. So keep that in here. Notice in here, here's a huge Flambeau box. So in here, as you see, terminal tackle. I label everything, I'm a freak about it. But this is where I keep all my giant terminal tackle. So bigger stuff that won't fit in my other boxes, my big swim bait heads, some little knickknack stuff. I keep my Scottsboro tackle, sniper heads there, split rings, you know, trailer hooks for spinner baits, buzz baits, stuff like that. Keep them in here. Just little knickknack things I keep in this box here. And I also have some extra spots for whatever. And here I also keep, if you can see in here, I keep my square bills, my trash jerk, my rattle traps, jerk baits, topwater baits, extra skirts. Now these are custom made by none other than Mr. Mark Detweiler, my dad, AKA the Jig Master. I don't even know, I just made that up. But so he makes all these skirts. He's just a freak when it comes to colors. He makes some really awesome stuff and I use it a lot. So we just stock this box full. If I need a new skirt on a bait or want to try a new color, something different, I'm loaded up there. So keep that right there. Always keep a spare prop. For those of you guys that don't carry a spare prop in your boat and you fish tournaments, it's not the most, that's not the smartest thing. Definitely keep a spare prop in your boat in case you spin a hub or whatever, break an ear off, whatever. So right here, got a little H2O bag. Keep all my glide baits in there, my bigger swim baits. They never leave the boat. Always keep them in there. Spare scale here. When I'm culling, I like to, you know, weigh them first. I have one back in the back, and I also keep one here. So that's my spare scale. Keep treble hooks in here. Got them all labeled. Again, if I need to change a treble hook on a bait, keep them all in there. Those are all new. Watertight box, you know, won't break. This is actually made by Husky, the tool company. I bought that at Home Depot. Right here is one of my favorite things about this whole, my whole setup here. I keep all my terminal tackle in these boxes right here. These are Flambeau boxes. This here is my weights, as you can see. Got them all labeled by size, what I use them for. You know, Carolina rig, you know, ounce and a half, big, that's just 2 ounces or bigger. So that's when you're flipping real heavy cover stuff. Here's my underspin swim bait box, scrounger, finesse, drop shot box. This one's pretty cool. One of my favorites, keep my drop shot weights in here. You know, Ned head, stuff like that. Then we got my tube shaky head box in there, and they all just sit in here real nice. I got a nice cool little crate in there, if you can check that out. Got a crate in there, little bin, keeps them upright. They don't fall over. Just keeps it real nice. I can go in there and grab them real quick. So that's that box. I just put this in here like that. Life jacket. All right, so that's that box. I keep my hard baits in there, life jacket, rain gear, stuff like that. We went over the day box. Now we'll go in here. This is my, I guess you can say my terminal tackle box, like, or my terminal tackle compartment. I keep my hooks in here. Spinner baits, jigs, chatter baits, buzz baits, all that stays in this box. It's a little smaller, so again, I don't need a ton of room, but I know what's in here. So right here, I keep my hooks in here. It's my hook box. This is how I store my hooks. I keep them in a, this is a Bass Mafia box. Got them all labeled again. Nico hooks, Tokyo rigs, flashy swimmers, drop shot, circle, screw lock hooks, EWG, worm hooks, and flipping hooks. Keep them all in there real nice. Keep them in the bags, keeps them waterproof, keeps them nice, and they're all in one box, so super easy. I know what I have. This is my Bass Mafia spinnerbait box. All my Nichols Lures spinnerbaits loaded up in here. Definitely got to keep them in the boat. I use them everywhere, so that box stays right there. I like these boxes, real easy to get to, so if I got to change a hook, I don't have to shuffle a bunch of stuff around. It's all right there. Here's my chatterbait box. You know, all I throw is the jackhammer. That's the only chatterbait I throw. I don't throw any of the other models they make. The jackhammer is my favorite. That's the one I have confidence in. That's the one I use. So smaller box, you know, I'm not going to have a million of these because they are very expensive. So keep them all in here. All my favorite colors. Like I said, I use these all over the country. So I just keep them in here real nice, and they stay dry. It's a waterproof box. You don't want them dudes getting wet. They're very expensive, so keep that in there. Here's some of my Nichols Lures. Again, simple basic colors, the colors I like, as you can see, shad color, bluegill color, black and blue for here in Florida, green pumpkin. That's pretty much it. You know, I keep, that's a bluegill pattern right there, pretty sick looking bait. Their swim jig. I'm also got some of their skipping jigs, you know, stuff like that. And then I have my buzz baits. We'll go to next. Buzz baits right there. Buzz. Got it labeled. So this is another H2O bag. As you can see, I keep that my glide baits in one. These I got at Academy Sports. These are all my Nichols buzz baits. I just keep them bulked up in here. And this is what I throw anytime I'm throwing a buzz bait. I throw the Nichols buzz baits, but just got the different colors in here. Also have the color numbers in here, so if I run out, I know what I need. And that's it. So keep them in the bags that I get them sent in, and then I also just put them in this Ziploc here, and then I'll zip it up. And it just keeps everything super waterproof, super tight, and you know, don't have to worry about my stuff rusting out or getting wet. If it's raining and I got to get a buzz bait out, I can open this and not all my buzz baits get wet. So cool little deal there if you're looking for a way to store your buzz baits. Awesome deal. So that's that compartment. Pretty simple, basic, clean, organized. I know what's in here. I love it. Also, if you look right here, this Basscat Air also has a fan built in it. So if you want to dry out your boxes, you know, pretty cool little deal there. So I'll show you that when we get back to the console. So that's that box. Now we're going to jump to this box. This is where I keep all my soft plastic. So it's kind of crazy, but first thing we'll show you is my Tackle Titan here by T&H Marine. Little magnetic system here, keep some baits on there, keep a frog. Just got back from Chickamauga. There's that Scottsboro Tackle sniper head I was showing you guys right there. Pretty cool little deal. They just magnetize up there, my baits. I need them. I can adjust this too. It's just a magnet plate, but that's that. As you can see, I keep most of my baits in these Mafia bags. So here's a Bass Mafia bag. I label them all. So here I got my chatterbait, swim jig, trailers, Senkos, sweet beavers, big old bag of sweet beavers here. Keep them jammed in there. Got all my favorite colors. Here we got another bag of Sweet Beavers. As you can tell, I love throwing the Sweet Beaver. Flipping it, jig trailer, whatever. Here's a big bag of Kinky Beavers and Man Bear Pigs. Keep them in there. Also, another cool bait I'll show you guys. These here are the brand new, see here, the brand new Top Secret. It's not really Top Secret anymore because they're out. But I'll show you here. There it is. Spicy Beaver 4.0. This dude is the bomb. I've been waiting for them to come out with this bait. As you can see, I got tons of different colors in this one. Tons of different colors in this one. I just keep them kind of bulked up. I got shad colors. I got, you know, your darker colors, your black and blues, your more natural colors. And I got them divided by that. Now, what do I use this bait for? Very versatile bait. You can flip it, put it on the back of a jig, chatterbait, you know, shaky head. You could swim it. There's so much stuff you can do with this bait. Very versatile bait. Again, there it is. Get some. We have them in Big Tahoe Marina. You can get them there. We got all the colors they make, so come check them out. Great, great bait. Really exciting bait. That was a bait I've been waiting for forever from Reaction Innovations, and they finally came out with it, so I'm super stoked about that bait. Getting back into the box here. I keep them right there, right up front here. Getting back into the box here. As you see, label everything, my mag baits, mag speed worms, regular speed worms, worms. I also keep some spicy beavers in a box. So here's some of them. This is actually the first batch I got before they even came out. So these were the colors I had, I got to play with before the bait even came out. So as you can see, you know, I got, you know, blank check, green pumpkin, watermelon red. So that's that. Also another cool bait that they make is the Glide 5.45. Awesome bait. I actually did a video on this just recently. The new Glide bait, awesome soft jerk bait, sick bait, love it. Got all my bait fish colors. That's what I, when I'm throwing a soft jerk bait, I'm trying to imitate bait fish. So that's what I have. Those are my favorite colors. That's that. Also got some small swim baits, some Kytex, and that's all I have for this side here. Throw that stuff back in there. Now we'll go to the rod box, show you all my rods. Pretty simple, pretty clean. Got them all just thrown in here. Spinning rods, bait casters, they're fishing rods. Nothing special, they're all Daiwa. That's what I like to use. And that's it. They're not a sponsor of mine, that's just what I prefer. Daiwa rods and reels. So that's that. Now we will jump back to the back of the boat and I'll show you guys the rest. All right, so now we're middle of the boat. You know, we got the console here. This area right here, a lot of things happen. So as you can see right here, I also have Tackle Titan. So I can hang baits here. They magnetize right there. I like them clean. I don't like a lot of clutter. So when I'm fishing an event, I try a bait out, I'll hang it there, let it dry, and put it away. I don't like a bunch of clutter down here especially. So here's a cool thing I learned from my buddy Carl Jockumson. It's the Wacky Tool Holder. Right there, a lot of people throw wacky worms, you know, traveling around the country, we throw them a ton. So I just keep that right there. Wacky tool, always have it, you know, accessible, very easy to get to. One of the coolest things that I do, this is something I do, I didn't see anybody do this, but I keep a boomerang tool right here. I put it on a Tackle Titan, I put a little clip there, a little key ring, and I just hook it to that. And what that allows me to do is just cut line super fast. You know, when I retie, I can reach there, it just hangs there, magnetizes there, whatever, it won't flop around. I just let it sit there. If I got to retie, cut line real quick, pull this out, cut it, boom, done, put it back. So that's that. Here's a tool holder here. I do not use this tool holder, and I will show you why here in just a second. I do not use that tool holder. I kick them around, scratches all that up, and I don't want that. So, and it's also clutter. You know, you hit waves, the tools pop out. I'll show you where I keep my tools. So that just stays like that. Here's the cooler. Pretty cool little cooler here. Actually, you keep your drinks in here, everything you want to keep. You know, that doesn't matter if it gets wet. And over here, they actually have a side for your sandwiches and stuff. So that's pretty cool. I do that. I keep, you know, my drinks in here, ice in here, sandwiches in here. And they stay cold because they're in the cooler. They just won't get, you know, soggy. So that's a cool little deal there. Cooler, very simple. Okay, so this is where I keep my tools. This is a glove box. On my last model boat, my last year's boat, I actually, you know, put my tools here and I kept other stuff here, and I'll show you why now I'm using this for my tools. Keep all my tools in here. Also keep all my sunscreen in here. Like I said, real quick access. I can get to it real quick. I need pliers, you know, scissors to cut other stuff. I got everything right here. Sunscreen, gotta wear your sunscreen. Always keep that easy access, and you know, it stays waterproof and, you know, looks clean, doesn't look bad. So here's the rod holder, you know, for your co-angler, whatever. This little thing right here, pretty cool. Some of you might think it's lame. I think it's freaking awesome. So this actually I bought on Tackle Warehouse, and what it is a, you know, to help you spool your line. So I keep a rubber band on it. Little tip for you guys, if you end up buying one, I put the rubber band on it because it rattles like crazy when you're going down the lake. So I put a rubber band on it to stop it from rattling. So when I put line on it to spool it on my reel, I pull the rubber band off, slide the spool on, and spool my line. So really cool deal. Just tapes on there, you know, 3M tape. It's not coming off. So, and you know, when you're done using it, it just slides in there and it's Velcro and it's out of the way. That is a cool product. I really love that product. It's really cool. I've used it a ton. It's not that expensive, so make sure you check that out. I bought it on Tackle Warehouse. I'm not sure the name of it, but I know it's on there, so check that product out. Really cool. Now we will go, I guess I can do, we'll just do this and then we'll get to the console. So under my seat, I got under my seat storage here, keep ropes, you know, microfiber towels, and this box here I keep all of my Starbright products, matte finish detailer. My boat wraps a matte finish, so this keeps it nice and protected. Also keep some vinyl guard in there, and vinyl clean for my seats. Pretty simple. Don't store a ton of stuff in there, but I know what's in there. Over here, we have my this little kind of passenger box. You know, I've kept the same stuff in this box even on my last two Bass Cats. Toilet paper, Dude wipes, gotta have that just in case nature calls when you're out on the water. If it doesn't call for you, then hey, that's, you know, your fault. Also, if I have the wife in the boat, we got toilet paper for her, so that's good. Always keep a first aid kit in the boat right there. Get people that hook themselves, whatever. I bought this at Walmart. It was like 20 bucks, so pretty cheap. You know, use that all the time. Keep a spare poncho in there, or a rain suit, just like a poncho pretty much, just something to throw over. Also keep more Dude wipes in there. You can never have enough Dude wipes, and spare sunscreen. Keep that in there too. So that is it for this box. Pretty simple. Like I said, I know what's in here. I've kept the same stuff in all my Bass Cats in this box, so I've always had a first aid kit in this box, and it's easy to get to. It's not easy to put away because I jammed it in there, but so yeah, that's that. Keep the toilet paper easy access. All right, so now we will go right here. So this is why on my last model boat, my last year I did not have this. This is new for this year for Bass Cat 2019. This is a center box. So on the last boat, I did have a center box, but it wasn't a glass box. It was more like carpet and a little smaller. This box is, you know, pretty big. So I keep my screen cleaner in here. In here I keep chapstick, cell phone charging cables, simple stuff. Advil, in case you get a headache, fish aren't biting, your mind starts spinning, and you get a headache, you have Advil. So that works. Also keep, you know, towel in here. Kind of goes way up underneath there. I also keep my cell phone, wallet, stuff in that, like that in here when I'm fishing. Actually just my wallet, my keys. I'll show you where I keep my cell phone. So that's that. And then this also opens up and it's a cooler, but you'll notice I don't keep drinks and stuff in there. I keep all of my culling equipment in here. So I got my G-Force culling system from T&H Marine. I keep my sixth culling float on here. I don't keep it in the live well because I don't want to have six fish in there. I've seen people do that too many times and then you're in trouble. So keep that in there. My G juice from T&H Marine in here also. G juice, gotta have that. This stuff's the bomb. Keep that in there. That's just all calling stuff, so nothing real fancy. Under this seat, now we're at the seat where I'm at, my driver's seat. I keep right here, we got a lure retriever, Daiwa lure retriever. Keep some extra scents in here. extra bubble box. I keep a bubble box just in case something happens. I have a, you know, a pump go down. I don't have any air going to my fish. I keep a bubble box in here. Just quick clamp it on my battery and we're good to go. So also keep a couple little extra tools in there. So that's under that box. And now we'll get to the console. All right, so now we're here at the console. This is like my dream console. This cockpit is amazing. So I'll show you what we have here. So right here, I got a Lowrance HDS 12 Live. And right here, I got a HDS 9 Carbon. Up front, like I showed you guys earlier, I run two Lowrance HDS Lives up front. This one, I got it on lock. So this one I have on a TH Marine Mini Kong mount. So real easy to get off when I go to the hotel, when I go somewhere, take it off real quick. Very easy to put back on and hook up. I love the KVD Kong mounts. They work great. I got the bigger one up there and the little one here. Just holding a 9-inch unit, so real simple. On here, I'll run my sonar, my downscan, side imaging, traditional sonar. On this one, I'll run full mapping and my Mercury Smart gauges for the motor. So that's that setup there. Pretty simple. Got my TH Marine Atlas jack plate gauge here. This little deal is cool here. So this is my RAM mount. I put my phone in there. Holds my cell phone, I keep it there. Reason why is the new HDS Lives will actually pop up your phone. You can actually connect your phone to them. And I'll show you right here. This is a little deal my dad and I came up with. Right there's some Velcro. If I pull this out, there is my little adapter. Plugs right into my cell phone. Pop it right there, plugs into my cell phone. And now my screen on my HDS Live will mirror my phone. So if I want to look at Google Maps, Google Earth, whatever, Navionics on my phone, you know, if I want to update stuff, CMAP, stuff like that, get it right here on the phone, and it'll show it right there on my screen. So cool little deal there. This is some hardcore Velcro, and then when I'm done using it, all I do is take the little adapter there, push it up underneath there, goes away. So cool little feature there, cool little deal my dad and I came up with. And that's pretty much it with the console. I got my hot foot down there, right there. Now look at all this room, okay? So you guys are probably wondering if you can see the leg room here. I'm 6'7", so for those of you tall guys out there looking to buy a boat, this is the boat for you. Basscat Era. I have tons of leg room. As you can see, my foot's right there on the hot foot. Tons of leg room. My legs are straight. So definitely a big, big, important deal for me. Some boats you get behind, you're all like jammed up, like a little dude, just all like crunched up, and you know, I don't like that. So this boat has tons of leg room for you if you're a tall person. Awesome boat. You don't have to buy it if you're tall. If you're short too, it'll work for you. No problem. No problems at all. So that's the console. Now we're going to get back to the back of the boat and check out the back. All right, so real quick, I'm going to show you guys. Here's the back deck. Not much happens back here for me. This is for a co-angler or if I'm fishing with, you know, family or whatever. So we're going to start off right quick here on the live wells. This here is, you know, the Basscat live wells, the famous Basscat live wells. I get asked a lot, you know, whoa, your live well is triangle. I'll explain to you why. So real quick, open them up here. This is new for this year. Pretty cool. Got the Basscat logo in there. You'll notice I keep all my call tags in here on the little TH Marine calling system here. Keep them right in my live well. Just grab them real quick, easy, hook them on. Done deal. So that's that. You'll notice why they're triangular, and I'll explain to you here in a second, but you see how deep they are. So if you look, I'll show you guys my arm. So again, I'm 6'7", so my arm's pretty long. My arm fits way down in there. They are that deep. They're pretty deep. So so not only are they deep, but the reason they're triangular, so if you have a giant fish, you have your you know, your traditional live wells, the square live well, your fish are gonna be kind of jammed in there. So whereas now, the live wells are cut the same way the lids are. So if you have a giant fish, it can lay this way versus where if you have a square triangle, you know, live well, they're gonna be, or a square live well, they're gonna be jammed in there pretty tight. So with this triangular live well, they're gonna be able to lay very long, straight, and you know, be comfortable. So that's the most important thing. You want your fish to be healthy and, you know, alive when you get back to the weigh-in. So never had any issues with these live wells. Got a divider in there. Co-angler keeps his on this side. I keep mine on this side. So pretty cool little deal there. There's the world famous Basscat live wells. Now we're gonna go back here behind my box. Pretty simple, you know, keep a little container in here. This is actually for a weapon, of course. Sometimes we keep our weapons on us, just, you know, to be safe out there on the water, while you're traveling, whatever. So keep a notepad in here. Some people may wonder why I keep a notepad in the boat. So this is Lake Chickamauga. I was writing down water levels, water temperature throughout the whole, you know, my practice, 7 days of practice. That way I can kind of keep a log on, you know, what was going on out there. So I keep that in there. Keep a tackle box full of Nature Valley granola bars. These things are the deal. As you see, I ate some, so I got to restock, but these are my favorite out there on the water. They're a little messy. They crunch, you know, they get a little bit of stuff everywhere. But if anybody from Nature Valley is watching this and you make a soft one, or if anybody knows of a soft one in the oats and honey, let me know, please. Comment below, because these things are amazing. I just wish they made a soft one so I wouldn't get crap everywhere. But so that's that little snack box. And here I also keep gloves, extra buffs, extra hats, amphibious sunglasses. Keep them loaded up. Gotta have my amphibious sunglasses. Keep all my little sand discs in here, all my little chips, my map charts, sea map charts. Keep some in there, keep some in here. My buffs, my sungloves. They're kind of just thrown in here because I wear them all the time. Every time I go out, I wear my gloves. So keep them in there. Got tons of amphibious sunglasses in there. And I keep the ones I wear out, of course, all the time. I keep them out. Always keep your Lowrance notebook with you, your little operator's manual. No, it doesn't mean you're stupid because you have an operator's manual on the boat. But if something goes wrong and you can't figure it out, I'm ready. So got that. Another cool thing. This is something I'm actually, like, some fishermen that I've actually talked to, you know, are actually starting to try this stuff. So this is called Zip Fizz. It's a really cool little powdered energy drink you put in your water. This is the fruit punch flavor. It's all vitamins, so it's not like a crazy, like, Monster energy drink or anything like that, or it's not going to kill you or make you jump in the lake and do cannonballs and stuff because you're like a crackhead. But it's going to, this stuff right here will keep you going, you know. You get, you know, long practice day, you start, you know, the energy starts wearing down. All you do is take a bottle of water, pour this in there, shake it up, and I'm like ready to go. I can go like another 8 hours or so. So awesome stuff, Zip Fizz. Like I said, you can buy it at Sam's, whatever. That's where I buy it. There's a couple different flavors too. Fruit Punch is the best. Some of the other ones are garbage, but this one's the deal. So keep them in a little container there. And I believe that's it for this box right here. Throw all that stuff back in there. I'll organize it when the video's over. I don't have time, but so that's that. Now we'll jump onto this side. This is pretty simple. All right, so I do have a co-angler, but my co-anglers keep all the stuff up front. If they have little things, they can keep them in here, but I keep my boxes pretty full. So here's a line bag. I keep my line in here, some of my line, mainly all my fluorocarbon. You know, I've got some Sunline here. I use a lot of cigar fluorocarbon, so I keep that all in here, kind of bulked up, keep some braid in there, whatever. That's the line I use, you know, throughout an event. You know, if I need to change line real quick in the boat, I can do that. And then right here is all my other line. So I keep all this in the truck, you know, mono, fluorocarbon, braid, keep all that stuff there. It's in the garage right now, but I put it in the truck. And then, you know, throughout an event, if I need to restock this, I can. So keep my line there. Keep some towels in here in case you fall in, or I don't know, you need a towel. Keep them there. Tools in here, fire extinguisher, another scale. And this thing is a lifesaver. And I'll show you here in a second. This is a Noco Boost. If I have a battery go dead on me, my starting battery, this thing has saved my butt a couple times. So just make sure it's charged. You just plug it into your wall. Comes with all kinds of stuff, little adapters. Plug it into your wall, charge it. Make sure it's charged before you go out in a tournament. And I'm not saying you have to charge it all the time. So all you do is hit power. See, right now it's on. So it's 100% charged. So I'm good. You know, if you need a flashlight, a little flashlight on it. Pretty cool little product here. So again, it's made by Noco. Not a sponsor of mine, just something, you know, you gotta have. saved my butt, like I said, a couple times. So, and I'll show you, I have a quick connect in the back of the boat. I don't even need to use these gator clips. I've actually saved some of my buddies out on the water with these clips. So I keep them in the boat just because, you know, if some of my buddies need to jump or anybody needs to jump. Now, it doesn't have to be one of my buddies, but I got you covered. So this little deal right there saves the day. So I just keep that in there, and I'll show you my quick connect in the back here in just a second. So that is that. And shut that without breaking my spools. That'd be bad. We'll just leave it open. I'm gonna have to fix that then. All right, so now we will go to the back of the boat. We'll go right here, and then I'll show you the other side. All right, so here we are on the back of the Basscat, the very, very back, the part that nobody looks at, but it's probably the most important part on the boat. So I got two gas tanks in this boat, 52 gallons, one on this side, one on the other side. And here I keep spare jumper cables. I just showed you guys the box, but just in case I forget to charge it or one of my buddies needs to carry some spare jumper cables for the day, I got them right there. Keep a power pole pump here, one on the other side. Now real quick, I'll show you guys that quick connect, which is right here. So this actually plugs into that NOCO charger, the jumper box right there. Plug it in, hit power, turn the key on the old Mercury, and it'll fire right up. So it's already connected to my batteries down there. So very easy. If I'm ever in a moment of panic, all I gotta do, like I said, is plug this in, hit power, motor will start right up. So I've actually had some really close calls in tournaments where I've had, you know, I've given myself 10 minutes before I got to go in, you know, and then I'll go to turn the key over and it won't start. So what I had to do, I remember it was a tournament on Toho, and it was a weekend series, a Bassmaster weekend series tournament. I gave myself 10 minutes to get in. I could literally see the marina from where I was at. I go to turn the key and the battery's dead. So I'm like freaking out. I grab jumper cables, I quick wire, hook everything up, and I jump the boat. And luckily I made it in with like a minute to spare. So, but that was like close call for me. And I don't like panicking. I don't like rushing at all. So you can ask my wife, I'm always on time, but I don't like rushing. So that was like freaking out for me. So this dude right here, real quick, like I said, connect it and go. So cool little feature there. That's pretty much it on this side. We'll quick jump to the other side. I'll show you what I got going on over there. By the way, the awesome filming is from my wife. She's on the camera. So if you've seen her foot throughout the video, it's her. So we're going to quick jump to this side. We're doing a little swap here. In the garage, I charge the boat. I just run an extension cord. Got the boat plugged in here. My dad and I, sorry, that's Jeff, the neighbor. No, I really don't know who it is, but so right here we put a little charging plug in here, plug the boat in, real simple, connects to the charger, you know, when I'm traveling, whatever, just hook an extension cord up there. Here's my charger. I run a Minn Kota Precision MK440 PC 4-bank charger. There you have it. Power pole blade pump, another pump there, another gas tank. All my wiring's nice, very simple, clean, organized. If I got to get to my pumps, I can get to them real quick and easy down there. If I have something go bad, Basscat makes them very easy to access, very easy to change. And that's it for there. Now we're going to go to this bad boy right here, my baby. This is a Mercury Pro XS 250 4-stroke. First year running a 4-stroke, brand new motor, just came out. I've actually had the privilege to run this motor before it even came out, before anybody knew about it. Actually, I had to sign a waiver so nobody knew that I knew about it. I couldn't talk about it, I couldn't do nothing, couldn't take pictures, none of that. But if you watch commercials on the new Mercury, it's me. Pretty sweet. So I'm actually in a lot of Mercury commercials for the new motor. I'm running a Basscat in the commercials too, which is awesome. Some of the other shots, I'm running other brand boats, but you know, my favorite day was when we were running the Basscat. We actually got this same model boat with this motor on it up to 81 mile an hour. So it's freaking fast for a 4-stroke, super quiet, fuel efficient, no oil. I love it. Goes through the grass. If those of you that are wondering how it goes through the grass, you know, here in Florida, it's amazing. So really there's nothing I've noticed different from the two-stroke, other than, I mean, I've noticed some huge differences in fuel economy and hole shot, and I don't have to put oil in it, but when it comes to like grass intake and stuff, haven't noticed any difference from the two-stroke to the four-stroke. So this thing is a freaking beast. It's bulletproof. I love my Mercury. It's a great company to work with, and the people there are awesome. So highly recommend if you're looking for a new outboard, or if you're looking to get a new bass cap, make sure you get the Mercury 250 Pro XS on it. I also run two power pole blades. I know it's kind of jammed in the garage here. It is a little tight, but I run the 8-foot power pole blades, black. They match the boat perfectly. Pretty basic, simple tool. I think most of you fishermen out there know what power poles are. Shallow water anchor. I use them for everything. I also have drift paddles. I run the drift paddles on them when I'm up north. Just an amazing product. It's like you can't live without it. It's like a trolling motor and an outboard. You need it. That's something you need on your boat. So highly recommend checking out power pole blades, 8-footers. They make 10-footers. Super quiet. Great for shallow water fishing. And also for deep water. Like I said, the drift paddles work amazing too. So that's it, man. That is the boat front to back. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks to my wife for filming. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. If there's any questions, comments, whatever, let me know. But before I end the video, I forgot something. So real quick, down here we need to check out the Atlas jack plate. Super awesome product. Again, shallow water performance allows me to raise the motor up and down. If I'm in shallow water, I can get out super shallow, skinny water with that jack plate. Adds to hole shot, top end speed, everything. So check out TH Marine Atlas jack plate. And now I'm officially done. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video again. Like I said, if you have any questions, comments, anything about the Basscat era, if you're looking to buy a new boat, check out Basscat. You will not be disappointed. Family owned business, amazing owner, and make sure you put a Mercury on the back and some Lowrance electronics. So thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see y'all next time.